Hi, I'm Andrew Mean and welcome to another Zapier video. Do you generate lots of electronic documents in your business and would like to know how to automatically create a document index? Well, if that's of interest to you, please keep watching this video. So the first thing I've done for this demonstration is create a document index. I've just used some of the information you might possibly use. You could add whatever information you wanted and you could pull that from the documents. I've also created a test document called tutorial, and now let's get into creating the Zap. So first thing we need to do is have a trigger, and that trigger is when a new Google Doc is created. So we'll select Google Docs and we'll choose new document. You could choose new document in a particular folder, and that might be more appropriate depending on your solution. Click continue. Now we need to sign into Google Docs here because I haven't signed in before. So this shows you how easy it is to do it. I'm signed in with Google, so select the account and allow. And let's click continue. And let's test the trigger. And here we are, we can see title tutorial, so that's the correct one. Let's click continue. Now the first thing we want to do is get some information specifically from that document so that we can use that to pass to the Google Sheet. So we're going to choose the formatter utility. That's one of the built-in tools in Zapier. So select formatter. And we're going to choose the text function. Now, before we do anything else, let's change the name of this because we'll be using text a couple of times and each of these steps will be called text. So click rename and we'll call this word count. Now we've selected text, we click continue, and we want to select the transform option, and if we scroll to the bottom we'll choose word count. Count the number of words in the string. So the string we want to use is within the information that it pulled from the Google document, so we'll choose the file raw plain text content. That's basically the body of the document. And we'll click continue. And we'll do a test, and it's come up with 256, which is the correct number. We'll click the plus sign to add another one, so we'll choose formatter again. This time we want to choose the title of the document. Now your title could be the file name, but as I've done in this case, it's not. It's the first line of the document. So let's use that, and it'll show you how to pull that information out. So again, we'll select text, and this time we'll change the name to document title, and we'll click continue, and the value we choose is created by using split text. Now what we want to split on is the first new line, so what we're going to do is we're going to add that input value here, and we're going to first of all select the area we want to review, so that's the body of the text again, so file raw plain text content. And the separator, certain characters have particular formats that they need to be put in Zapier. You can find those by clicking on this link down here. So you'll see here there's some optional special characters that we can use. In this case we want to use the new line. So we'll copy that. Paste that in there. New line. Segment index is going to be first, and that's the section before the new line. So we'll click continue and we'll test that one, and it should give us a title. What is up here and how do I use it? So let's add our next one. Now what we're going to want to use is the date. Now the date format in the document will be slightly different. It will have the time. In this case we don't want the time, so we're just going to use formatter again. And this time we're going to select the date and time option. We're going to select transform and we're going to use the format option. The value we'll use is the creation date of the document, which has been pulled already. Created date, And we want to change it to a particular format. Let's say we want to change it to the day, month, year. You could change the time zone if you wanted. In this case, I'm not going to bother. You could also choose the from format if it wasn't in a standard format and you needed Zapier to know how it was originally put together. Click continue. We'll do a test. And you can see 25th of the 8th, 2020. Now we have all that information, we want to add that to our index. So this time we're going to select Google Sheets as the action. And what we want to do is create a new spreadsheet row. Again, we'll need to sign in because I haven't signed in this case. If you sign in, it will go straight to the next option. We'll click continue. Don't need the drive, knows which drive, I've only got one connected. We're going to use the document index, which is the file that we've created for this purpose. Now you have to choose worksheets, even if there's only one. So we'll select that there. And here you can see the list of the fields that we've asked to be used. So for our title, we'll create a document title with formatter, you recall. Use that. The file name, we can get the file name from the Google document that we pulled in the first step. Now it calls it the title, that's why you need to be careful with the title. It might not be the title of your document. That's the file name. The link we can also get from the action step or the trigger step. Word count, we created word count. Author, I'm going to use the document owner in this case. And the date added is the date and time that we formatted earlier. And if we click continue and run a test, we should see a test spreadsheet row was sent to Google Sheets just now. So let's go to that row and you can see it's created all the information we want and we've got the link to our document. Now we can turn on this zap. And that zap is now waiting for a new document created. So let's create a new document. I've got some information here, we'll copy. And we're going to go back to Google Docs and we're going to create a new document. And we're going to call this one Tutorial 2. I'm going to paste this in. And this time we'll just add a little bit more text. Just to differentiate it. Now that's been saved, we can go back to our document index and wait for that to be updated. Now you need to remember that it can take up to 15 minutes to update depending on the version of Zapier that you've purchased. You can change that to 2 minutes or 1 minute if you choose one of the higher price models. So I'm just going to speed this section up for the purposes of this demonstration. So you can see there we have it. A new title has been added. We've got the extra word reflected in the word count there. We've got the new link to the new document and we've got the new title. Well, I hope you enjoyed that automation video. If you did, please click the thumbs up. Please also click subscribe and I look forward to seeing you for our next video.